Man Live, we bump into England legend Devon Malcolm. How are you, Devon?
Oh, not too bad, thank you. Very good. Here in, shall I say, sunny-ish Durham this afternoon, yeah.
Good stuff. You enjoyed the series so far, particularly the performance of Stuart Broad.
Indeed. Stuart been one of the guys who performed really well this summer. He always delivered, you know, largely delivered. And you know, everybody keeps saying, okay, you know, you haven't been constantly taking the fifers, but he bowled really well here, and he's a very useful batter as well. So, you know, he's a fine cricketer to have in the team, because if he doesn't contribute with the ball, he generally contributes also with the bat, yeah.
Jimmy Anderson as well, passing the 400 mark too earlier in the series.
Indeed, a fantastic bowler. His record is speak for itself. Yes, he's done really well in the first two test matches. Bowled really well at Old Trafford without the result. He's, you know, that will happen. You know, nobody's going to get out there and take five wickets every innings, whatever. But showing a bit of form, got a couple of wickets first innings. So hopefully he produces a fifer in the second innings here to try and win this test match. You know, the Australians certainly will be fighting. They won't be, you know, giving up easy. But we just need the guys to keep the pressure on, really.
Well, I have to take you back, Devon, to 94, the Oval, 9 for 57 against South Africa, one of the most lethal spells of fast bowling England fans, cricket fans indeed around the world must have seen. You must look back on that very fondly indeed.
Yeah, it's quite a while back actually, yeah, but it's one of those memory-making moments, and it's almost 20 years now, probably 20 years next year this happened, and you know, a lot of people still talking about it. Obviously, it was only a few years ago. But yeah, it was one of those times. South Africa, first time they came back into international cricket. I was calling for the final test match at the Oval. We were 1-0 down. And it happened, charging, and took 9 for 57. And at the time, it was the sixth best bowling analysis in the history of cricket. But it was one of those things where everything clicks. I was in the zone, you know. And a lot of people said, you know, I ended up taking 9 wickets in that game. Was it a hit on the head by Farnie de Villiers that did that? All I said to that was just a little extra fuel on the fire, because the morning before I felt so good, I actually told my coach we were going to take 6 wickets. So if the hit on the head, probably give me extra 3. But yeah, it was one of those moments where everything clicks. All the catches were taken and I was in the zone, put it that way. Yeah.
It's a nice payback to de Villiers' ball though. He did hit you on the helmet. You know, that must have rolled you slightly, and certainly the reaction from the South Africa slip cordon as well.
Oh yes, indeed, because I mean, you know, as I said, I bowled really quickly in the first innings. And when I came into bat, I could hear the South African boys in the slip field. Like, come on, let him have a bouncer. I weren't expecting it. I thought it was a double bluff. We're going to hit me a Yorker, actually. But he bowled a perfect bouncer. I didn't even move, and he hit me right between the eyes. So I was slightly embarrassed. So as I said before, when that happened, I just turned around to the boys in the slip squad and the South African guys and said, look, you want to see what fast bowling is about? Wait till you guys come out to bat. You guys going to be history, and that what it was, 9 for 57, and you know, I really let them know what I really meant that day. But as I said, the hit on the head, you know, extra fuel to the fire, put it that way.
And the atmosphere when you take those 9 wickets must have been sensational there at the Oval.
Indeed, I mean, the spectators, you get out there, you try to please the fans, you try to bowl for the fans, but on that day it was unbelievable. The crowd was just, you know, amazing, you know. And over the years, I said that been happening almost almost 19 years ago, and over the years people keep saying, oh, I was there. I tell you what, if I get a penny every time somebody say that. I didn't realize the Oval held a whole 200,000 people, but at least 200,000 people, I believe, over the years keep saying I was at that game. I keep saying somebody got to be lying. But yeah, it was one of those memory moments. You know, they don't care where people was on that day, if they're watching the game or listening on the radio, somehow they've been transported somewhere to the cricket. But it was one of those moments that's, you know, stick with a lot of people, and one I won't forget in a hurry.